Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Glyza Escolyar. Hi, Glyza.
Good morning, Bettina, and this is the latest on the weather. The intertropical convergence zone will bring cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Zamboanga Peninsula and Palawan. Flash floods and landslides is possible due to moderate to at times heavy rains. Meanwhile, Metro Manila and the rest of the country will have partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms, mostly in the afternoon or evening. The temperature range for Metro Manila is between 25 to 33 degrees Celsius. From the Weather Forecasting Center of PAGASA, this is Glyza Escolyar reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Glyza. The former President Rodrigo Duterte speaking at length on several issues, including the whereabouts of fugitive televangelist Apollo Quiboloy. He's also denying the announcement of his daughter on his plan to run for Senate next year. Robert Mano reports.
Fugitive Philippine televangelist Apollo Quiboloy has been the subject of a manhunt by authorities, but he has so far eluded authorities. Over the weekend, Quiboloy's ally, former President Duterte, claimed he knows where the high-profile pastor is holed up, but refused to say where. The leader of the Kingdom of Jesus had appointed the former president as his property administrator. Quiboloy is wanted on charges of sexual abuse, human trafficking, and money laundering here and in the U.S. This revelation invited criticisms from Bayan Muna Chairman Nery Colmenares, noting that Duterte should know better. Colmenares argued that as a lawyer, Duterte should uphold the rule of law and conscientiously assist in the speedy and efficient administration of justice. He also calls for a thorough investigation on why authorities have failed to arrest the pastor and hold accountable to those who are helping him hide. Meantime, Duterte denied the pronouncements of his daughter, Vice President Sara Duterte, that he and sons Paulo and Sebastian are gunning for a Senate seat in the next year's midterm polls. Duterte insists he has no intention of returning to politics.
Nawala ka ginday. Idyamin ka niya na gusto. Wala naman pag malabag yung mga tanong. Sagutin ka ng malabag niyan. So ka makakita dito tatay pati dilong anak magtakbo ng... Ante hindi na ako bumalik ng politika. Tapos nabuo ako. Laos na ako. Wala na akong panggastos, wala na lahat. Ang naiwan sa akin siguro yabang.
A political analyst believes the supposedly conflicting statements are a way to gauge public perception.
The Duterte, like I said, has already been fond of doing, no? Yung tinatawag natin na reluctance. Maganda yung impression na na-create nito, no? Na parabang hindi sila ganid sa position, they're not really too greedy to be in power. Pero nga, over time, when you keep on doing the same thing, yes, it creates some kind of public confusion. And at the same time, it may erode yung trust doon sa integridad ng mga binabanggit mong mga salita. This could be a part of the strategy talaga, no? In order for them to assess two things.
However, Kalilong sees the possibility of the former president seeking a Senate seat.
Hindi natin maikakaila, no? Maaring in the future, maaring may mga destabilization against her, an impeachment case might be filed against her. Kung nandoon si President Duterte, si ex-President Duterte, magkakaroon ng konting buffer, no? Magkakaroon ng pambalanse.
The former president also weighed in on the supposed plan of former Senator Laila De Lima to go after those behind the bogus drug charges filed against her. De Lima, a vocal critic of Duterte's drug war, has been acquitted of all charges. The former senator blames Duterte and former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre for her 7-year-long detention. Duterte, however, issues this warning against De Lima.
Yung ginawa niya, she has shame for generations to come. Yung magdadala ng pangalan niya, do not tempt the gods. Find your peace where you are now. Huwag kang kumalikot ng away kasi pagsisihan mo yan.
Meanwhile, the former president gave an unsolicited advice to President Marcos Jr.
We paid you. We elected you and we are paying you. Magtrabaho ka. Do not worry. Nobody, but nobody, is interested or are natanggaling ka. It's a waste of time.
Robert Mano, ABS-CBN News.
Former President Duterte accusing the Philippine government of letting itself be used by the U.S. in its rivalry with China. Duterte believes this is what's causing the worsening tension between Manila and Beijing.
We were free to fish in and out of that area. Nobody was bugging us. And there was no issue of territory. We were not molested. We went there to fish, to make my countrymen to make a living undisturbed. Ito na lang ngayon na bago itong diskarte. Pero alam mo, hindi ko ma I would be storytelling kung ano talaga nangyari. But alam ninyo kung bakit yan. What started the rockos there? Well, let us start by never mind the people that America is using or that is a part of the geopolitics of America. And the Philippines ginamit. So, eh, nagpagamit. So, kanya-kanyang depende sa kung sinong nag-opo.
Despite the escalating maritime row between the Philippines and China, Duterte says the situation remains manageable.
I don't think that it could go out of control. We have not reached that level of animosity or severity in the hostility with China that would warrant trouble for the country and for China also. It's I might just say siguro still within the diplomatic ambit.
During the Aquino administration, the Philippines took China to court and won, invalidating Beijing's illegal claims in the West Philippine Sea. But Duterte's foreign policy was marked by his pivot to China. At one point during his presidency, Duterte even called Manila's arbitral victory a piece of paper that should be thrown in the trash. The Filipino fishermen rescued in a boat engine explosion near Bajo de Masinloc denying China's account of the incident. See a report from Chinese state media Global Times claimed the Chinese Coast Guard helped the fishermen on board the sinking boat. But the Filipino fishermen say Beijing even attempted to block the Philippine Coast Guard's rescue efforts.
Balita na sila daw tumulong sa amin eh. Hindi naman eh. Dumating yung ano natin, yung barko natin ng Pilipinas na inaarang ng Manila, ginigit-git pa nila eh. Bahit sa inyo na yun.
Ang sabi nila nga, kung sakaling makatulong yung Chinese Coast Guard at lumapit yung BRP sindangan at ikukulong kami diretso.
Two of the eight fishermen suffered severe burns and are still in critical condition. They are appealing for assistance for their treatment. Aside from a high-ranking former cabinet official, more politicians have lobbied for POGO licenses. Gaming regulator PAGCOR made this new revelation Monday, but it remains tight-lipped on the identity of the officials involved. Lawmakers have been urging PAGCOR to stop what they call blind items to hold the alleged POGO protectors accountable.
Dapat pangalanan ng PAGCOR yung di umano dating cabinet official na ranking cabinet official noong nakarang administrasyon para naman na hindi mapagdudahan lahat ng ibang mga cabinet, former ranking cabinet officials. At kung hindi gagawin ng PAGCOR yon, marapat ay usisain at alamin ng komiteng nagdidinig dyan sa kasong yan ngayon sa pamumuno ni Senator Risa at ni Senator Wayne Gatchalian.
Sana pinangalanan nila itong taong to dahil nagpapatunay ito na yung mga POGO ay meron silang koneksyon sa mga matataas na opisyalis natin.
PAGCOR meanwhile gave assurance it will reveal what it knows in the next Senate hearing on POGOs, which will happen on July 10th.
Malalim po kasi yung ginagawa nating pagsasaliksik. So binuklat natin talaga lahat ng mga records para hindi ho tayo magkamali at sigurado tayo dun sa impormasyon na hawak natin. Nung nagsimula na pong umint yung issue, nagsimula din po ang PAGCOR na balikan lahat ng mga records ng mga nakaraang mga nabigyan ng mga lisensya, mga natanggalan ng lisensya. So medyo nagtagal po.
Now, Philippine Senator Sonny Angara willing to take the helm of the Education Department. Angara's name has been floated as a possible replacement for Vice President Sara Duterte, who resigned as DepEd Secretary last month. But he clarifies he has yet to receive any offer. Even without a formal offer, Senate President Francis Escudero gives a glowing recommendation for his colleague. He believes Angara is the best man for the job.
I was one of the first, if not the first, to actually recommend him to become a Deputy Secretary, given his competence, given his track record, given his experience in the education field. The term of Senator Angara will be expiring in June 2025 anyway. So hintayin na lamang siguro mag-expire yun. So if the Senator will accept it, if he is appointed, there will only be 23 sitting Senators.